Hello everyone. So today we will be discussing the restricted Boltzmann machine. So what is RBM? RBMs are shallow two-layer artificial neural network, with first layer being the visible and the other being the hidden. Each circle represents a neuron-like unit called a node. Nodes are connected to each other across layers, but no two nodes of the same layer are linked. Each node processes input and makes stochastic decisions about whether to transmit input or not. And these neurons are binary states. This neural network tries to learn probabilistic distribution over its set of input. So now consider a traditional feed-forward network having four layers with 784 input units. Here, activation of a neuron in a given layer is computed by performing the dot product of a weight vector with the activation of the prior layer and adding a bias term and then applying the logistic activation. Same formulation can be applied to RBM, but with one exception. Instead of this procedure determining the activation of a hidden neuron given the input, it determines the probability that the hidden neuron will have the value 1, then the hidden neuron is randomly set to either 1 or 0 according to its probability value. Next, we will be seeing on the working of RBM. Each node of the visible layer are connected to the first node of the hidden layer with weights W1, W2, W3 as seen in the figure. The input of the hidden node is the dot product of the weight vector with the activated units of the visible layer added to the bias term, and the result is passed through the activation algorithm producing one output of each hidden node. Okay. RBM is an energy based model. This is the energy equation, which is a function of visible and hidden units. B and C are the bias vectors of visible and hidden layers, and W is the weighted matrix. This is the probability equation and is represented as a function of energy. Here, Z is the normalization constant. Next, we will be going to see why RBM uses the sigmoid function. This will be fully mathematical. We will start with the conditional probability P of H given V is equal to P of H, V divided by P of V. Now, we will substitute the probability values which we have studied earlier. Here P of V is nothing but similar to P of H comma V, but we will be summing over H. Now, after substituting the energy equation, here the term B transpose V is independent of H. We will separate it and cancel it out. Now we will take the case of H being 1. Now we will use the result here by putting H equal to 1. This equation is in the form of a sigmoid function with X being C transpose plus V transpose W. Okay, next is the learning process in RBM. It is done in two steps: Gibbs sampling and contrastive divergence. Gibbs sampling is the step in which the model tries to predict the hidden unit for the given input vectors in the forward pass and the input unit for the given hidden vectors in the backward pass, that is reconstruction. The notations will be like probability of H equal to 1 given V for given visible inputs, and probability of V equal to 1 given H for given hidden inputs. This is done for infinite number of iterations in ideal case, but in practical we can say like for T times or K times. And the contrastive divergence step, the updation of the weights and the biases occur, that is here in this case W, B and C. So new weights W suffix new is equal to sum of old weight and delta W. where delta w is the difference between the product of probabilities with input vector at initial case and at t. Okay. So the next step is the gradient descent algorithm that is used to train RVM. The common way to train is to determine the parameter that maximizes the likelihood of the observed data. The mathematical formulation is given as L of v, comma theta. It's nothing but the summation t equal to 1 to n log of probability of vt, where vt is nothing but the observed data at t. Probability of v, we have studied earlier, like probability of v is equal to probability of v, comma h, summing over all possible values of h. Substituting the probability values, and we will be performing these steps as shown here. To determine the parameters, we perform the gradient descent on the log of the likelihood function. So applying the gradient descent, so we will be differentiating with respect to theta over this equation. We will get the final equation as shown here. So the last equation here, EP, E suffix P is the expected value under the distribution P. Thus, the gradient of likelihood is composed of two parts. The first part is expected gradient of energy function with respect to joint distribution over all variable states. And the second part is expected gradient of energy function with respect to conditional distribution. So, hope you understood. Thanks.